League. Babe!
I just felt so helpless.
Babe, stop.
I couldn't help her. I was so hurt. So whenever I found that out, I was driving, but I was shaking so bad. My hands were shaking, and I was like, I hope I don't get in an accident trying to get over here. So it's like, the hospital was probably like, I said like maybe 10, 20 minutes away. So I pulled up to the hospital, and you already know the hospital, Cape Fear is always packed in the emergency room. It was like no parks. So I'm mad about that because I really wanted to just drive up to the thing and just leave my car open. And I was just, oh my God. It was just so much. And then like everybody knowing what's going on except me. Like I was just mad. What if I was on that side of town? It was so many what ifs going through my head.
Stop rubbing your eye. I know you're crying, but I don't want it to get worse.
Go ahead.
I think she has a sty. I think she do have a sty, but...
Go ahead.
Babe.
Go.
Okay, I'm sorry. You're going to make me emotional. So, I had called her. I called my grandma. Stop.
What? I'm good okay. now.
All right, I called my grandma. I told her what was going on, and my grandma was freaking out. And I felt so bad because it was her car, and I didn't have driver's license and all that. I called her, let her know I was in an accident. I think she called my dad, or I called my dad. I can't even remember verbatim, but my dad came over there. I called my best friend because she was down the street. Her and her mom came, and her mom and her brother,
they stay in a neighborhood near there, and they were passing by leaving out of their neighborhood, and they were like,
and of course, I'm sorry, I just have, of course she had to like sit there because it was an accident. So in the time of like trying to move the car, and you know, it was too much traffic basically, in the time of moving the car, she was just sitting there. And I guess her brother told her mom that
I think my mom noticed.
She knew. Oh, okay.
Ever since like before then, Deanna and her best friend had came to pick me up at my parents' house, and I think they like already knew, like just by face. And then my mom called me. She was like, what color shirt does your girlfriend have on today? And I was like, you know what I'm saying? Somebody asked you a question like that. I wasn't even thinking like nothing cheating or nothing like that, but I'm just like, weird. Like, what do you mean by that? And that's when she was like, she on the side of the road, like she got in a car accident. And then DJ was like, yeah, that's her. And I'm like, bruh, it was just so crazy to hear. Like I said, being so far away, like where she was at from where I was at, it had to be at least 30
minutes. And her brother was just sitting there, like in the back, just watching.
He was really scared.
I don't know, because I really didn't talk to her brother like that, you know, at all. I was just dating his sister. So I don't know if he felt like kiki about that, you know.
Yeah.
But yeah, I was thankful that her mom was there, because she's actually a registered nurse. So of course she knew what she was doing. And she was like the only nurse there at that time, like trying to calm me down, because I was just crying and I was just helpless. I just felt like not like I did something wrong, because of course that was my grandma's car, and you know, stuff like that. And my grandma called.
To this day, it's like, sorry, I didn't mean shit. Okay. But it's like, I don't even understand how, like, at me as a parent, when I get older, if my children wreck my car, I would not dare have the words to come out of my mouth like, you wrecked my car. It's like child car, and it's like the child weighs way more than the car. So it's just like, you know, for you to say that, it just made me think about that, like how selfish people can be in this world. Like, it's just crazy.
Yeah, so basically that happened. The ambulance came, my grandma finally came, and my sisters came too, and I had to basically go to the hospital and get checked. And they asked me if I wanted to go or not, and I'm just like, no, I don't need to, I'm good. But I had blood all over me, So I just was admitted to the hospital. Well, I went in the ambulance for the first time. And I was responsive. I was texting Keys the whole time there. My best friend was there. She was crying too. Everybody was literally crying around me. And like her mom, Miss Shonda, she literally was just trying to calm everybody down. And I'm just like, you know, she even told my grandma, calm down, it's okay, don't cry, stuff like that.
I think her nurse instincts kicked in.
Yeah, and like everybody was just shocked. Because it was like me out of like all people in the world. You know how many people on this earth die over car accidents? And I was able to get out of this one, being the circumstances that I was in, as far as the boat flipping over and then the passenger side. What if it was the driver's side? What if I was paralyzed? You know, stuff like that. And I'm blessed to this day to be able to see daylight, live my life, and all of that.
I sometimes feel like that's why your eyes are sensitive to light.
Yes, I think so too. Because now my eyes are like crazy, amongst other things. Like, it's just, I don't know. I just need to get it checked. But anyways, I go to the hospital. My grandma rode with me. She said she would never ride in the ambulance again. Because they were so fast, of course. And my dad was going too. But he was driving my dad parked his car at Nisha house. And then he drove the Trailblazer to, and Nisha, everybody was just at the hospital. Then she called my grandpa, Jackie, she called Uncle Julian and Kim, and everybody was just at the hospital. So I was admitted. Oh my God, my first time having an IV, and it would hurt like heck. I think I had it in my hand. I don't know, one of them hurt. Again, I was just so happy, and I was just so, I just kept crying and shaking because I just felt bad. And that's when the police came in and basically said that, like, I owe a ticket. I was submitted a ticket. I was 18 years old, so of course I'm responsible for paying a ticket. I didn't have license, so that was basically what happened. I don't think they charged me for that. It's not even on my record, thank God. And basically the police came. They were saying that to be quite honest, they said that it was my fault. I was in the wrong of the accident because I had the stop sign. Now, if I was in his predicament, I would be safe because it's a oncoming thing. They don't stop at all. They just keep going. Being that I was at a stop sign, which I understand it because I was at a stop sign, and I basically tried to hurry up, not like rush, but go ahead and go over because the car obviously was still coming. I just didn't know it would be so fast, you know. So basically, they said it was my fault. I don't think they sued or anything. I don't think they sued at all.
Mm-hmm. So fast forward, cause it's like,
oh yeah.
Let me tell right here. After like, you know, being at the hospital, they run your X-rays, they do all that stuff, everything checks out, and it's like, Deanna's family was like, okay, so you, everybody was like, kind of like shocked that she said she still wanted to go to prom. Yeah. Even after all of that, like everybody was.
And this
like,
was the day. I don't know if I told y'all, but this was the day of prom. Yeah, I did. So I literally had prom 4 hours or 2 hours later. Mm-hmm. So 4 hours later. Yeah. So
all I remember was like, we had to go to prom. My hair was halfway cut because I didn't have a chance to get my hair cut again. And Deanna had to rush to get ready. But it was like me. I'm not going to say I was mad that she still wanted to go. I understand that, you know, that's something that you don't, you know, want to miss, but I didn't go to either of my proms. That ain't got nothing to do with this, but I didn't go to either of my proms, but I was kind of like, dang, I feel like you should take it easy. But at the moment, I was just so glad, like, you know, she was still able to be up, moving around, right, talking and stuff, so I didn't really want to be like a killjoy by saying, like, I don't think you should go. So it was like, when we went, I didn't feel like I could really be her date. I felt like I had to, like, be a bodyguard because people didn't really know, like, for her to be so banged up, like, she was sore.
I had bruises all over me.
She had bruises everywhere. So it was like, you know, when people see you, they might hug you. They be like, how you doing?
And I kept telling them, I just got an accident. Even though I know people going to say, hey, I just want to let them know, like, I got an accident. People were, like squeezing we weren't being rude, and I was just aching. Yeah, it's just I didn't want to be. I just wanted to have a good time, even if it was just sitting. I didn't go to my 11th grade prom. I went to my 12th grade prom under the circumstances that I was just in a car accident. So at that time, I was just chilling. I was happy that I was, of course, alive and just trying, you know, trying to have a good time. And, of course, I went. I didn't go to school for a couple of days because I was still bruised up. But I didn't want to miss prom, honestly. My grandma spent money for a dress. I felt like that needed to be worn.
Yeah, so it was like, it was crazy because we still went. But it was like the whole time while we was there, I constantly felt like I was on guard. Like, you know, if she turned her body or something like that, is somebody going to come over? Because I can't remember who it was. And if you know the name, we ain't going to say it. Somebody had, like, hugged her, like, you know, like, kind of firm. And I had gotten mad because it's like, if I see bruises on somebody, that's just me, though. I'm not going to
I don't think she's seen it because you can barely see any bruises.
Oh, because the room was kind of like dim a little bit. Okay, so I'll take
that. So I really can't be mad at her. But after I told her this, hey, I just got an accident.
Everybody was
I just got an accident. I had to say it two times. So, yeah, everybody was like, dang, you okay? Stuff like that. And, yeah, so that's basically what happened. And I went to prom. I'm happy I did. Keys was there. And then later on that night, I went and slept over Keys' house. Slept with Keys that night. And then we
got like a hotel.
Went to sleep. And just
and it was honestly chill, but I felt so bad because it was like all the newness of everything was wearing down. And it was like, okay, the accident is over. Okay. Like, her family, you know, called to make sure that we made it back in and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody was, like, being so supportive and stuff like that. But it's, like, as everything was drawing down, everything was wearing off. And so, like, the real pain was starting to kick in. So, it was, like, she was, like, ow, I'm hurting. So, I'm just, like, dang, like, and what else can I do?
The crazy thing is, like, I have two uncles. Uncle, like, he was about, like, he was literally, I think he was wearing shades. He was about to cry. I don't know if he was crying
or what. Yeah, he was crying. Everybody was crying. Her sisters were crying. And it was like, me and her sisters, we were both, like, all of us was trying to figure out, like, trying to rationalize, like, what if this, what if that? And I was like, trying to stop everybody from like going through that process because like when something bad happens we have to deal with the issue.
What was y'all doing up there?
What you mean, like what were we doing out there? We was just like talking, like, you know, trying to figure out exactly like how everything happened and stuff like that.
Was Nisha's mom up there?
I can't remember. All I remember was I was kind of getting impatient because of course our family and stuff was going back there, but I was ready to go back there to see. And then Deanna was like, wait, I didn't cry when I seen you. But I did feel like I had to be strong when I seen her. Because if you hurting and somebody crying, it's going to make you panic more. Like, dang, do I look that bad? That's just me thinking.
Who came back with you, Zaria?
Or no, Nisha came back with me.
Nisha.
No. It was either Nisha or Nana. Oh, yeah. And then I think that was the first time I ever spoke to her grandma.
You said hey?
Yeah. I think people were surprised to see me there.
Yeah.
Well, once I found out, I was like, I was on 2 weeks.
My people knew that I was gay at the time, but of course they didn't like it. But I was 18.
Yeah. So.
Yeah. So that's basically what happened. I'm gonna definitely insert pictures. I've already inserted some pictures. If you want any more story times like this, I think we covered everything, right?
What, as far as story time?
Yeah, no, the accident.
Yeah, we covered everything that I feel like we would need to take, like, share with y'all.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, when we do this stuff, y'all, it's not really to, like, give y'all, like, we don't want, like, sadness or pity or not like that. But we want our YouTube channel to be very transparent. So when we go through things, we want things to be real, like real life that we can connect with people. Maybe it's somebody out there that just went through an accident or something like that. We just want to connect with people.
God forbid, though.
Yeah.
If you do.
We just want to connect with people. So it's like, we want to do things that normal people go through and they struggle with and they have to deal with. So that's why we felt like, you know, it was smart for us to talk about this video. Like you said, if you guys enjoy when we do story times, please give this video a thumbs up. If you don't like that, please feel free to give us a dislike. We are not perfect, and I am not, you know, gonna get upset if nobody gives us a dislike. That's just corrective criticism that I can definitely handle. I could definitely use that to, like, come up with better ideas for you guys. Thank you guys for watching this video.
Y'all didn't think she was... I didn't know. Like, y'all, she cried. I was not expecting that. I didn't know you were gonna get emotional.
You never know. Because I always be acting like... I don't act hard at all. Because I'm a goofy person. What?
You don't act hard. Not in front of y'all, but...
Not really. I don't act hard like that. I'm really, like, a goofy person. I just like to crack jokes.
Well, thank you guys for watching this video. If you want any more story times, definitely let us know. We have multiple stories on what happened between our lives or even her life. If you want to hear more about military, about her part of the military, definitely give us a thumbs up and comment below on what you would like to hear about the military or what she went through in the military as far as, you know, how was it like? How was the recruiting stuff? How was
my job?
Right. What was her job and everything? So if you want to hear any more story times about the military or anything personal.
Or just story times, period. If you have idea, drop it in the comments below and we'll definitely, you know, try to get to it for you guys. Also, this is going to be our last video here for a couple days.
We're
meeting somebody very special. Well, two people very special tomorrow. And we're going to put them on the vlog for y'all. Like I said, thank you guys for watching this video.
And this video may be uploaded tonight or maybe just edit it tonight, but upload it tomorrow. So we'll see. We had a 2-hour layover and I might insert the music here.
What music?
In the city where we layover did.
I am dead. They don't know about that.
All right, thank you guys for subscribing. Like, comment, and subscribe. Make sure you hit that post notification bell so you can make sure you're catched up. So you can make sure that you're caught up with what we have going on. Again, thank you for watching, and we love you, KD family. Peace.